I say, you there. Yes, you. Hello there. I'm the town's resident photographer. Cameron's the name. Cameron Obscura. I hope you don't mind me asking, but have you ever taken a photograph yourself? You have? So you already know how to use a camera. I suppose a seasoned traveller like yourself would, yes. Which means you're aware that pressing the start button allows you to look through the lens. And that taking a picture is a simple matter of pressing the A button. That being the case, I hardly need tell you that each photograph is automatically added to your album. What with you knowing already, I mean. I wonder if I might ask you a little favour, actually. I'd be very interested to see how good a photographer you are. Perhaps you would indulge me by taking my picture. Once you're happy you've captured my true essence, let me have a look and I'd give you my professional opinion. Ready to show me the fruits of your labours, eh? Come along then, let's have a closer look. Not bad. Not bad at all. I was right about you, I see. You have a fine eye. Do you know, it's a little hobby of mine to collect photos of singular sights from around the world. I used to travel a lot, you see, but it's become so dangerous, I don't dare venture very far these days. I really do miss it, though. And so, I was wondering if you might take some pictures while you're off on your travels and come back and show me every now and then. Oh, that's splendid. In that case, let me give you this. I'll use that book to set you photographic challenges, quests to find special places and unusual monsters from around the world. If you manage to take a picture of the quest subject, you may rest assured that I will reward you accordingly. I've actually prepared a little practice challenge to start you off. Let's see if you're eagle-eyed enough to take the picture I'm after. Just come back and show me when you've got it, all right? Well, happy snapping and good luck!
I don't have time to argue. I want you to put out to sea now.
My apologies, Miss Jessica, but the waters are simply too dangerous at the moment.
Haven't you been listening? I told you I'd take care of that.
Please forgive me, Lady Jessica. There'd be hell to pay from the Albert family if we put you in danger.
Is there anyone around here with half a brain? Ah, speak of the devil. You're the travelers from the tower. Didn't I tell you to wait for me in Alexandria? I wanted to properly apologize to you. Well, whatever. I'm glad you're here now. Actually, I have a favor to ask. Would you mind coming over here for a minute? So, you're saying you won't let me fight the sea monster?
Well, yes, but what I mean...
Fine, fine, not to worry. I've asked these sturdy men to take care of it for me. Okay?
Oh, well. Actually, we've been looking for someone to take on that very job ourselves.
Well, there you have it. Everyone's happy. Can I count on you guys? I knew I could count on you. I still can't get what we saw in the tower out of my mind. Who is this Dual Magus? And what does he want? And why did he murder my brother? I'll track him to the ends of the earth. But first, we've got to make the waters safe for ships to sail. The sea monster that's standing in our way is supposed to be pretty strong. You'd better be prepared. I'll be waiting here. Come back as soon as you're ready. Are you ready to set sail? Okay then. Quartermaster, prepare the ship.
Aye, aye, sir. Set sail! Weigh anchor!
No, I hate this tender.
No, I hate the tootickles, these nasty humans and their ships. Always sailing over poor Calamari's head.
Yeah, Tenta, yeah. Humans don't have no manners.
That's right, Tickles. They don't have none at all, they don't. No!
That's why Calamari's gonna stand up for all the poor creatures of the sea, starting by eating these here humans.
Yeah, Tickles, yeah. He'll eat him. Eat him right up!
They were stronger than we thought!
We give up! We give up!
Sure, it wasn't our fault, though. It was his.
That's right, it was.
That jester, he came walking on top of the water to us. Just walked over us. He did. Pretty cheeky of a human to pull that little trick off, we thought.
So we talked to him, we did.
No, but when he talked,
our head got all cloudy-like, and we started attacking ships.
We did. No, it wasn't us. It was that jester. It was.
Is this by way of an apology, like?
Oh. Well, we found it in the ocean. We did.
Go on, take it, mate.
It's the least we can do.
Well, that is all from us. We are leaving now. We are. Have a pleasant trip. So long.
Not bad, guys. You're a lot stronger than you look. You know, we've never properly introduced ourselves. I'm Jessica, Jessica Albert. And who might you be?
I'm Yangus, and this here's the Gov.
Yangus and the Gov, is it? Right. Thanks again for your help with the sea monster. Now, let's find Dormagus. I'm sure you need to get ready first, so let's head back to Port Prospect. I'll tell the captain to weigh anchor. Forgot. I called you two thieves back at the tower and I never formally apologized. So, forgive me. Anyway, I'll talk to the captain.
All hands on deck! Weigh anchor and prepare to come about! We're heading back to Port Prospect!
Monster, so I got them to agree to wait for us. I figured you'd like to rest and buy provisions before we set sail again. I'll be waiting for you here. Don't take too long now. We've got work to do.
Thank you.
Actually, before we go, I have a favour to ask. You're after Dolmagus just like I am, right? We're fighting for the same reasons. So, I was thinking, why don't we do this together? I've got a great feeling about this. Thanks, guys. Well, now that's taken care of, let's go.
Just where do you think you're going without me and my beautiful princess?
All hands on deck! Weigh anchor! Prepare to set sail for Peregrine Key!
Ah, there you are. So what are you two up to?
Up to? Me and the Gav was just talking, that's all.
Gav, huh? I've been meaning to ask you about that. You know, he doesn't exactly look like your governor. If anything, it looks the other way around. What's the story?
Well, I'm glad you asked. The story of how me and the Gav fell in together is an epic tale. Full of laughter, frills and tears.
It is it? Well, why don't you just give me the highlights?
All right, I will. It all started on a fine summer's day. The sound of insects was deafening. I just decided to make a clean break of it. I was well acted off with the old bandithood. So I decided to leave the town that I lived in my whole life and start afresh like. I ain't exactly a looker, as you can see. Perhaps that's why people treated me funny, everywhere I went, like I was a thief or something. I didn't have no place to go, and not a penny to me name neither. So I ended up going back to the old game. And that's when I run into the Gov here. Hold it right there. Who gave you permission to use my bridge then, eh?
Permission? Permission? Your bridge lies within my kingdom, you oaf.
What are you on about? A creepy old codger like you? A king? Don't make me laugh.
I see your mouth is as vulgar as your face. Yes, I'm the king. And who exactly do you think you are?
Me? Hearing my name is enough to make anyone wet their knickers. That's right. You're talking to none other than Yangus, the legendary bandit himself.
Yangus?
The one and only. Time to cough up. You have to pay if you want to cross my bridge.
The one and only Yangus? What a shame there aren't more of you. Now kindly remove your one and only self from my bridge and clear off.
Don't push your luck, you green-faced freak. I would have let you go if you'd have kept your gob shut and paid up. But you want to do this the hard way, eh?
Now, my boy, now's our chance to cross.
Just my bleeding luck.
Now that's what I call just desserts. As the saying goes, crime doesn't pay. Let us carry on then, my boy. There, there, my precious Medea. Did the bad man scare you? What are you doing? But he attacked us! Why the devil are you helping him? Just leave him! It's poetic justice! Nay, divine justice!
Thank you, Governor. I thought I was done for.
What is the world coming to? Yengus, was it? You can show your gratitude by getting out of our sight.
You're having a laugh.
What? Still here? If you...
Mister? No, Governor. I really owe you. You saved my life and everything. You're the bee's knees, Gov.
Gov? What is this nonsense? Are you a complete imbecile? This boy is my retainer. If you're in anyone's service, it's mine.
Put a sock in it. I ain't talking to you. He's the one who saved me.
Put a sock in. Who do you think you're speaking to, you good-for-nothing scoundrel?
So that's how you met. But what happened to all the laughter, thrills, and tears?
Well, I'm not finished yet. This is the best bit. I haven't told you about how the Gov helped me go straight.
Whatever. You can tell me all about it later. Right now, I need some fresh air.
I should have known a bird wouldn't get a story like ours, Gov. Still, no skin off my nose.
did it! I did it! I finally did it! Ah, there you are! Perfect timing! I've got something to show you! Ta-da! Looks like a normal pot, doesn't it? But it's actually a legendary alchemy pot. I can see that doesn't mean much to you. Allow me to explain. The alchemy pot is an invaluable tool for making different kinds of items. It lets you mix different ingredients to create hard-to-find items, armor, and weapons. After my kingdom was cursed, I thought it might come in handy and managed to spirit it out of the castle. But that's not all. I spent night after night trying to get it working again. No, you can thank me later. Right. Well, it's in my carriage, so why don't you give it a try? It's surprisingly easy to use.
Captain, land ho!
Belay the rigging and prepare to make port.
Aye, aye, sir.
Helmsman! Bring us alongside Peregrine Quay!
It looks like we've arrived. I'll meet you outside town with Medea and the carriage. It wouldn't do to stir up the natives again with my extraordinary appearance.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You